The economic efficiency of nuclear power plants is the biggest swindle of our times. Forbes magazine wrote, "The failure of the nuclear program of the United States is the biggest corporate catastrophe in economic history, a catastrophe of monumental magnitude. Only the blind or someone biased can believe that the billions of dollars spent were a good investment. The salary of a security guard working for 1 million years would cost many billion euros, and the effort needed to control the highly radioactive waste is hard to imagine. The nuclear industry has never been efficient. It would have gone bankrupt immediately had it been forced to bear the real social costs it is creating. It is made cheaply because the public pays the bill and carries the risk."
Take, for example, Francis Bacon's famous expression, "Knowledge is power." Everybody knows this, but not the rest of his sentence, which states, "Therefore, we have to trick nature in order to discover all her secrets." That is the first pillar of modernity. It's the control of nature. And the second is growth. Growth is the prerequisite for achieving more wealth, more power, more prosperity. That's why John Locke, one of the fathers of the Enlightenment and of modernity, said that the more growth, the more man will resemble God. This is a complete misconception which influences the way modern man thinks until today. From my point of view, these two fundamental pillars lead towards the threat of wars about resources and energy. It all started with controlling and destroying nature and by striving for constant growth, which results in power and greed and the desire for more and more. Only a few hours after the devastating tsunami on March the 11th, 2011, the meltdown of Fukushima followed, and the worst disaster in human history took place. We then saw how they tried to cool it down by spraying resin from above and using floating rafts from the coast to clean up the radioactive and highly contaminated water. All of this was false propaganda.